American families caught up in the forces of change. One mother seeking a better life for her children.
They can call you a lot of ugly names, but it's not the first time and it won't be the last.
Another fighting to protect her family.
There were cops watching us like we were criminals or something.
And a man whose plans and hopes for the future are about to be tested.
I think we ought to get out.
You don't mean that.
Each convinced right is on their side.
We gotta show the judge we're not gonna back down.
And each willing to stand up for a belief. But can the families endure the struggle ahead?
I put my child on a bus, and you fill a home with blood on our bread.
And now, the powerful true story, Common Ground.
Cassandra Twyman. In 1968, I lived in Boston. My neighborhood was called Roxbury. Everybody was black there. I had four brothers and a sister, no father. Mommy was determined we shall all get a good education so we would grow up to really be somebody. But to be somebody, you had to learn to make it in the white world.
Good morning, children. This morning, we're going to do the multiplication test. The five times. Five times one, Michael.
I will never forget my grade school. It had dirty floorboards and papers on the floor. I remember an old broken window with a sign on it saying, "Do not unlock, this window is broken." There were cracks in the wall. The books were old with ink poured all over them. I remember old torn alphabet letters hanging on the wall. A, B, E. The fire exits were dirty, and we had a new teacher most every day. Pigeons used to fly all over the school.
Five times six, five times five.
I remember a stick for whipping standing in the corner underneath the flag of the United States of America. The desks were broken and had writings all over the inside. Everything in that school was dirty and smelled like pee.
Five times seven. Five times eight.
Bring that up, it'd be to lay me down. He can't take care of his own family. He can't take care of himself.
If I die before I wake...
Cassandra, you've been fighting. What's wrong with your hands?
The teacher whopped me with a rattan.
Whopped you for what?
Miss Jones, she whopped the whole class for not telling you to the eraser.
I hope there's some learning going on there.
I can't hear nothing back of the room. That old window creaking. Yesterday, it just come crashing down, and Mr. Duquin come running in saying, "Gee, glad it didn't hit the niggers."
Mr. Duquin said that?
Now I lay me down to sleep.
Pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I die before I wake, pray the Lord my soul to keep.
Amen.
Had a long talk with my daughter last night about what those little boys
are saying. Mrs. Randall. Mrs. Lyman. You're all Richard and George's mother.
And Frederick and Wayne and Cassandra's, they here. But I want to see for myself the things going on.
What sort of things?
Well, books like this, falling apart. Calling Negroes savage and uncivilized. Are my daughter's classrooms down where the toilets are next to the boiler room? Every day she goes to school in clean clothes and comes home covered with coal dust.
The Gibson School is one of the oldest in the city. It badly needs Set of facilities, up-to-date materials. I have been trying to get the funds from...
Now, what funds do you need to stop teachers from calling our children racist names?
Mm-hmm. I simply don't believe that.
You don't believe what?
It just doesn't happen here.
I'm Lisa McGough. My neighborhood was Charlestown. It was only across town from Roxbury, but it might as well have been in another country. Most of us were Irish, and all of us were very patriotic. Nobody ever missed our Bunker Hill Day parade. That's when the British found out that we Americans were going to stand up for our rights and not get pushed around. We were a big family. We were poor, but we were proud. My mother believed in the American flag and Jesus Christ.
Is it your will that Thomas Francis should have had an application to be a vote? I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. God the Father now. Christ was anointed as priest, prophet, and king, so you may live as a member of his body, a wife of his.
Pardon me for putting it this way, Father, but having Tommy nearly killed me.
There was a priest in the room in case Alice needed last rites.
Well, you have a fine son.
Oh, we're thankful for that, Father, but the doctor said I shouldn't have another child.
The thing is, we wondered if the church could, you know, sort of give us special permission.
Contraception is a mortal sin.
Is it a sin to want to take care of my wife, Father?
And you have to practice the rhythm method.
That would never work for us. We're only 25.
Live together as brother and sister.
Father, I grew up with three sisters. I didn't marry Alice because I wanted a fourth.
Alice, we want to take some pictures.
He doesn't care whether I live or die. He doesn't care whether I leave five kids behind.
They've got their rules.
Oh, geez, Danny, what have we been through?
Down at the point. I told my father Foley said. You know what he said? He said we can follow our own conscience.
Too late, Danny.
What do you mean it's too late?
I'm pregnant again.
I'm Colin Diver. In 1968, I was graduating from Harvard Law School. All I knew was that I wanted to get out of those libraries and into the real world. I believed in America, but I wanted to make it better.
Like a motherless child, singing freedom along.
Hi, sweetheart.
Hi.
Hey, kiddo.
Did you accept?
Mm-hmm.
You don't look very happy about it.
Oh, I'm not. I don't know why. This is supposed to be the best time in my life. I got my pick of law firms. Oh, Joni, my head is killing me.
It's all right. Maybe 2 years of the law review has spoiled you for the real world.
No, it's not that. Tyler does a tremendous amount of pro bono work.
Boy, sat on the porch and lie down.
Come here, you. What do you think I ought to do?
We interrupt this program to bring you this special news bulletin. Civil rights leader, the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was shot late this afternoon outside a motel in Memphis, Tennessee. He was alone on the motel's balcony at the time, and local police have no suspect in the case at this moment. To repeat,
What's the matter with him? Someone just killed Martin Luther King.
King had gone onto the balcony for fresh air minutes before due to leave for a meeting and a rally in downtown Memphis. He was alone on the balcony when the shots were fired and appeared to have died instantly.
No.
Reaction in black communities across the country.
Where's your brothers? Where's Frederick and Wayne?
Why are you crying, Ma? He wasn't one of our family.
Because the one he got killed for, Cassandra, makes him my big brother. Because he wanted all of us to be equal. And there's other things, too. I used to go see Martin when he was a student minister over at 12 Baptist. And he was so fine up there, looking down at me. Made me feel like I was...
Rachel, there's trouble down by your store. Better get down there.
The buses and subways are shut down. We'll give you a ride.
Oh, at least the grave's still in place.
You want us to drive you home?
No, I think I'll stay here, just in case.
You sure?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, let's go.
Thank you.
Los Angeles, New York, and Detroit. Rioting in Washington, D.C. was particularly severe.
What are you kids doing, Stilla?
Mom, look at this. Is this real?
Yeah, I know, and so am I real. Bobby, Kevin, go to bed right now.
Come on.
Come on, go to bed now.
Please.
Now, now, now. Go. Come on.
Martin Luther King Jr. dead this day. Felled by an assassin's bullet, April 4th, 19.
People think they're doing.
They're burning Blue Hill Avenue.
It's crazy. We didn't burn down Charlestown when President Kennedy got killed. Niggas. I think they're the only people got it tough in this world.
I said I'd believe it if I felt it. Well, I can feel it.
Introducing new Extra Strength Denerex with conditioners.
This shampoo is different. It tingles. Feels like it's doing more. It's definitely Denerex.
Both Head & Shoulders and Denerex have dandruff medicine. But only Denerex adds an extra anti-itch medicine that tingles and conditioners.
It's definitely Denerex.
Definitely Denerex.
New Extra Strength Denerex with conditioners.
For great looking hair.
That's right.
Look at them. They're all so ancient.
Is this what happens to review editors when they get older?
I don't mind being a boiled shirt. Off Washington's here. Off Wall Street.
The Holocaust that ripped through our cities over the last 2 years, indeed over the past 3 weeks, gives ample testimony to the magnitude of the problem. If we are somehow to escape destruction, we must accept the proposition that the plight of the black man is the greatest single crisis in America today. The time has come for me as mayor of Boston, after 100 days in office, and for the nation after 100 years, to put, as Lincoln did, the preservation of the Union above all else, the creation of a single society of white and black above all else. This is our commitment in Boston. I need your help. I hope there are those here among you, the very best young lawyers America has produced, who will choose to join us in this commitment.
Thank you.
He's asking us to help him out. Who knows if he even has tiny jobs? Well, I'm going to find out.
Got to get out of this tenement, Alva.
Last week, a junkie robbed George down at the laundromat.
Why don't you get your own washing machine?
Now, tell me where I'm going to get the money for that.
Just get off your butt and make a little money.
All I ever hear from you, money.
Hey, Richard.
Where's your necktie?
Freshman's gonna burn their ties to protest those dudes wearing jai dashi.
Oh, no, don't you go burning no perfectly good $3 ties.
Then we all got let out early because the bomb scare.
Now, what kind of education you getting up with English anyway?
Black power, sister. Back to Africa.
I'm just about sick of this brother-sister crap.
Well, you're gonna hear a whole lot more because our brother going and took some Arab name. He ain't Arnold no more. He's Hassan Sharif.
Hi, Ma. Hi, Aunt Ella.
Hey, Cassandra.
Girl?
You are doing a whole lot of growing. Where'd you get that dress?
Ma made them.
I can see that.
Cassandra, clean up your room before you come in here.
Give her a break, Ray. She just got home.
Do I tell you how to raise Charlene and Marie?
Now, what is wrong with the way I dress my children?
I wouldn't let mine get caught dead wearing no mammy, man.
Oh, and where does Miss Astor do her shopping? Filene?
Barbara? What man you got giving you money now?
I'll work for my money instead of living off welfare.
I do not live on welfare.
And I don't mean no slave wage.
I am running on my feet all day that shop.
I have got
and
two jobs.
I can't take the salary.
I don't have
until
to
live
on those damn projects. I don't know why I even bother coming over here.
Either do I.
Kevin's office.
You think we can be here?
Well.
Mr. Mayor, I'd like you to meet my wife, Joan.
Oh, Joan, how are you? Well, you're in great shape, I see.
Mr. Mayor, I'm happy that Colin's working for the ideas he believes in.
Well, we're proud to have Colin here. You know, this man's here 5 minutes. And not only has he found a source of revenue around town that no one ever knew existed, but he's got the city suing those arrogant SOBs down at the Port Authority.
Now that's sharp political instinct.
Oh, by the way, Colin, I've been meaning to ask you, is it true you're here because you took that speech I gave as a personal invitation?
Well, yes, I guess I did.
I didn't mean it that way. But we're damn lucky to have you.
For too long, we have been like Jonah in the belly of the great whale. For too long, we have relied on politicians who paid us only lip service, stolen our name, our rights, our heritage. For too long, we have been fallen among thieves. For too long,
the new
we have been drilled in the virtue of poverty and patience. Mm-hmm. We cannot leave the present injustices for history to correct.
No.
We must call into question the present order of the world.
Hey, man, get back in line.
You got a problem?
Yeah, you. I wait my turn, you wait yours.
Yeah, I just want a milk.
I just want a piece of pie.
Shut up, nigga.
Back off.
You hit a white boy in the head with a tray?
Why should I take crap from him, whether he's black or white?
Because you get suspended, that's why. How can you get an education if you're not in school? You hit every white man in Boston calls you that you are outside the school.
Hey,
boy, you must have lost your mind.
Rich. Sit. Brownies are good. How come you put pecans in?
Because I didn't have no walnuts.
Richard's right, you know. I know you don't like to hear that because Ma, she brought us up to be real nice to white folks no matter what they were shoveling on.
It's still a white world they're living in. You think that's going to change, Arnold?
Hey.
Excuse me. Hassan.
If that's what you really believe, then the best thing you can do is to get your kids out of black ghetto schools so they can learn what white is. Don't be waiting on the school committee for help. Them bigots will go to jail before they integrate. I'm telling you, I miss the walnuts.
I'm Colin Driver of the Mayor's Home Rule Commission.
You're the guys who want to take over the Boston School District, right?
Not exactly. We're studying ways to simplify the structure of city government.
Same thing.
The commission wants to know what you think of certain proposals, such as enlarging the committee and electing the members by district rather than at large.
You want to know what I think? I think it's a ploy by the mayor to pick up two or three colored votes in order to shove the phony Racial Imbalance Act down the throats of the people of Boston. That's what I think.
Are you saying you don't believe there's segregation in the schools?
Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. The Jews are not a pan. Italians in Eastie. Irish in Southie and blacks in Roxbury. That's not segregation, my friend. That's neighborhoods.
According to your own department's figures, the number of racially unbalanced schools has increased from 46 to 67.
That's because they're more colored. They keep moving in, and the whites keep moving out. So you liberal social engineers come over from Harvard to tell us we got to push our kids all over the city. And somebody pins on a map. And the only way to do that is on a bus. Well, people of Boston won't stand for it. And that's why they elect people like me. To tell the mayor and maggots like you where to shut their Racial Imbalance Act.
I met some members of the school committee today. School is the last thing on their mind.
What mind?
They're only interested in politics, patronage, and pandering to the racial fears of their constituents.
I like that. You know, you're a born speechwriter. Keep the popcorn moving.
I think you ought to abolish the committee. Make the superintendent directly responsible to you.
As long as there's a committee, no one's going to blame me for their problems.
Okay, what if you just sat on the committee?
Colin, I love you. But if I'm publicly identified with those idiots, I'm going to be held responsible for what they do. God. You love this stuff as much as I do?
I'm a chips man myself.
Listen, I've been thinking of running for governor. How would you like to come along as my legal counsel?
I'm very flattered, Kevin. I'd like to think about it.
Stop thinking, because I want you with me.
He hasn't the faintest interest in Boston anymore. All he cares about is the damn governor's race. He's only using City Hall as a stepping stone to the State House, and he wants me to be his legal counsel.
What do you want?
I'm half hoping he'll lose. I went to work for him because he cared about this city. If he doesn't anymore, well, I still do. Just wait till you see the table. With Joni, they got everything down there. Black, Greek, Asian, a lot of young couples moving in. Lots of kids. Just look at these. Old townhouses. Aren't they beautiful? No more boring commute. We can walk to work, walk to the theater.
So, Brad and Ned grow up here?
Their friends would speak six different languages. Better than some suburban white bread ghetto. Joni, there's a whole other world going on here. What do you think?
Okay.
Got you.
our family had a piece of luck. Got us all hopping with excitement. Mommy got us out of that funky old tenement and into a clean new project. Well, nearly new. Me and my little sister Rachel didn't have to share a room with our brothers anymore. And Mommy had a bedroom all to herself for the first time that I remember.
Last time y'all broke it.
Look, Sandra, it's a playground. No, I don't want that
magic. Get off of it.
I want that magic.
Rachel, get away. Stop acting like a baby.
I got it.
Yeah, get it from the back.
I'm in the middle.
Okay, bring it right up.
All right. Come on, get the kids off the stairs. Excuse us for...
The project was right across the street from some really beautiful streets. My brother Richard liked to go walking in those old places. He said it made him feel good just being there.
Boston.
You lost the city by 17,000 votes.
Come on, give me the neighborhoods. How'd we do in Southie? Roslindale. Roxbury. My own people did this to me. Why the hell didn't you see this coming? That's it! I've had it! To hell with this city! Wrong.
Southie hears you talking over their heads to the Googers in the suburbs.
They think that you're too trendy. They think you're too pro-black. They think you're giving away the store.
Wait a minute, Ron. We compared expenditures in both the black and white communities. There isn't a dime's difference.
No, it's not just the dollars. Charlestown and Dorchester see all the attention the blacks are getting. Model cities, affirmative action, a deputy black police superintendent, and they don't like it.
What you're saying, Larry, is there's a lot of bigots in Boston.
No, what I'm saying, Colin, is you can call them what you want. They're just a lot of votes.
Okay. Just let me
Let me think this through. I've got to start addressing the psychological needs of the city of Boston.
That's right, Mayor. Forget the suburbs. Start talking tough. You know, tough on drugs, tough on taxes.
And tough on crime.
That's nonsense. Those are just right-wing code words for dumping the blacks. You are suggesting we dump them. Lost Boston by 17,000 votes. Next time around, we pander to the fear and bigotry of the neighborhoods because they deliver the ballot box, right?
You said what?
I just couldn't take anymore. Everything that attracted me to City Hall in the first place has become a political liability. Everything.
Are you losing your faith in government?
No. Not government. Politics.
Then you're doing exactly what you should be doing. You're yelling and screaming. You're keeping Kevin honest.
Try to avoid it?
Oh, you think we're going to steal your money?
We're not afraid. We live on this block.
Oh, is that a fact? Then you won't mind shaking hands with a black man.
Don't you touch him.
You think that umbrella's going to protect you? You point that damn thing at me.
You leave him alone.
Yo,
excuse me, ever try this coffee?
Oh, no. I use special gourmet beans.
So do we.
Ah, roast them to perfection.
So do we.
I brew fresh, rich coffee.
So do we, but then we freeze dry to lock in superior fresh brewed flavor and aroma until you release it.
Mmm, perfect. Who are you?
We're the only ones who do all this. We're Taster's Choice, the choice for taste.
When you find a car with this much room in the rear seat, this is what you expect to find in the front seat. Acclaim. First class travel for the price of coach.
Now, take advantage of the $1,000 guaranteed rebate on Plymouth Acclaim.
This new toothpaste will blow you away. With a breath freshener that's a brush of fresh air. It's new Aqua Fresh Extra Fresh. With an extra minty, extra fresh breath freshener. That beats the leading brand. So next time you brush, get cavity-fighting fluoride and plaque-removing power plus an extra fresh breath freshener all in one. New Aqua Fresh Extra Fresh. It's a brush of fresh air.
That's me, Tommy Lasorda, before I lost 30 pounds in 3 months with the Ultra Slim Fast plan. Now, that was last June, and the big news is I haven't gained an ounce back. The plan is easy. I had a delicious shake for breakfast, one for lunch, and then a sensible dinner. I feel great, and I'm never going to look like this again. Hey, if I can do it, you can do it.
Ultra Slim Fast. Give us a week. We'll take off the weight.
Common Ground will continue.
Monday, it's a different kind of...
Yeah.
to dinner. Aren't you going to give me a kiss?
Come on, kid. Come on, get out of here. Your dad's not feeling well. Come on.
There's talk down the point that the government's going to shut down the Navy Yard. That's most of my customers. And all of yours.
What's the matter, Danny?
The matter is, I'm going to be 35. My uncle died when he was 35.
Hey, I don't like that kind of talk. What's your uncle got to do with you anyway?
I don't know, Alice. It's a funny feeling I got is all.
Come on. You're getting to sound like your customers on a Friday night. Such a blanny gloom and then a nice big fight. Come on, eat your supper. Come on. I had an uncle who used to eat quahogs just like that. Lived to be 95.
He married a townie. Catherine and me used to sleep over each other's house.
The problem is, some people, they just get too good for where they come from.
Hey, this is Mr. Power! Mr. Power!
Who's that?
This is the headmaster of the high school, dummy.
There's Father Joy. Hi, Father Joy.
Yeah, let's get out of here. Come on.
What am I going to do, Father?
God bless you with five fine children.
Six. I'm a widow with 36, with six kids in the project, and a minimum wage job. What am I going to do?
Put your faith in Christ, my child.
Father, what am I going to do?
Honey, I feel terrible for you. Where are the kids?
They're home. I don't want them to remember their father in a box.
Thank you.
Right this way. Here. May I wait?
That's nice.
Thank you. Sure. Boss, we got big problems with the Lee School in Dorchester.
The school was built with state funds, provided an open balance.
Now the neighborhood's black. The school committee just voted 3-2 not to bus white kids in.
The school committee's problem.
No, Mayor. It's your problem. I don't have to appeal to you for my liberal principles on this. The state can withhold $200 million in school construction funds, which means you'll have to raise taxes in an election year.
You better eat that fast before it helps.
I'll get that, sir. Hold on.
All right. All right. Now, who's in charge of the swing vote in the committee?
George Crawford.
Well, let's see if we can switch his vote.
Too late. He switched his vote already. The wrong way. So now the black parents are going to sue the school committee as being segregationist.
Hallelujah.
We submit, Your Honor, that the school committee has broken its promise to the children of Boston. It has knowingly carried out a systematic program of segregation, in effect maintaining a dual school system, one black, one white.
The citizens of this city tend to live in tight ethnic enclaves. Now, if there is a disproportionate number of blacks to whites in certain schools, Your Honor, it is not by intent of the school committee, but by natural neighborhood boundaries.
Where were the natural boundaries when district lines were redrawn protecting white students from black neighborhood schools? What is intent when the school committee deliberately opens the Lee School imbalance? Why did black students arrive at open enrollment programs in white schools to find doors locked, classrooms segregated, desks unbolted from the floor and removed from the classroom altogether?
All things being equal, Mrs. Morgan, wouldn't you rather see your children go to school 3 blocks from home rather than ride a bus 3 miles into, say, Charlestown?
Yes, but all things are not equal.
Don't you agree that your children should have black teachers as role models?
Yes, I do. And so should the white children.
TV says everybody's jumpy because busing's coming. Everybody blaming everybody else. Well, it hasn't come yet. Mommy got us in an open enrollment in Eastie. They don't give us those bad looks here. Maybe because they're Italian instead of Irish. Maybe because there's just 3 of us.
How come we gotta go to school all the way out in East Boston?
Yeah. Tell him, Cassandra.
So we don't have to go to no nigger school in Roxbury or Dorchester.
We gotta... Did I tell you to talk like that?
Well, ain't it the truth?
My friend Marie and me talk about boys who show off and algebra's a bitch and our moms give us a hard time and stuff. She even invited me to her house. Her ma gave me a flower. Just 2 petals on this page. My favorite thing is combing her hair. It's black like mine. It feels alive in my fingers. She's the best friend I ever had. Don't tell that to nobody.
Hey, come here. Where do you think you're going?
My car. I ran out of gas.
Hey, ain't you that same bitch I told stay out of this part of town yesterday?
I live here.
Yeah? Where you live?
Pewin Street.
Where you live before that?
Germany.
Yeah? Will you get back to Germany, yeah? You don't like white folk, you understand?
This
unbelievable act of violence makes every decent person wince with shame. That this atrocity, the death of this young woman, could happen in Boston. But it would be a tragic mistake to view this crime as anything other than isolated insanity. To blow this up into a racial incident would be a terrible disservice to the city.
Please, sir, Mayor,
how do you think
this
will affect busing
in the city?
Isn't that Mrs. Stratton's car?
They're getting back at the niggas for running the white girl in Roxbury the other night.
But she's white.
Yeah, but his wife ain't.
Hey, come on, you kids, get out of here!
Hey, come on, give me some of that.
What's missing from New Hillshire Farm light smoke sausage?
It's got that same juicy taste.
Same smoke flavor.
What's missing? This.
New Hillshire Farm light. It's missing 25% of the fat found in the other leading brand, but hasn't lost one bit of that great smoke sausage taste.
The only thing missing, as far as I can see, is another helping. Come on.
New Hillshire Farm light smoke sausage and Polska kielbasa with 25% less fat.
I'm taking care of Ernie, Mommy.
And I'm taking care of you. Here's your vitamins.
Ernie!
My kids like Sesame Street vitamins because of the shapes and natural flavors, and they're age-formulated, so both my kids get 100% every day. I like that.
What do doctors recommend most for the aches and pains of colds and flu? Not aspirin. Not anymore. In fact, doctors now recommend Tylenol 14 times more than aspirin for the aches of colds and flu. Tylenol, recommended the most by the people who know the most.
Clock is ticking, Charlestown. It's later than you think. The state Supreme Court is telling the school committee to start busing 17,000 kids at the beginning of next year to different schools. You know what that means, don't you? That means white kids to black schools. And black kids to white schools.
Oh, no, I like that idea.
The NAACP is telling the federal government to do the same thing.
What is he saying?
Listen, Alice, listen.
The mayor and his liberal cronies who live out in the suburbs want to turn Boston into a black city.
No!
They want to send your kids to Roxbury.
No!
I got an idea. Why don't we bus all those black kids out to the suburbs?
Charlestown's hitting you over the head with this busing thing.
Same thing in East Boston. They had a meeting there last night. Place was packed. Pixie Palladino's out to hang busing around your neck.
My neck? It's a damn school committee's mess.
If they had committed to equal opportunity 10 years ago, we wouldn't have a racial imbalance law.
Well, we do, and they're still refusing to obey it. Healy said that he'd go to jail for it.
Ah, he's just grandstanding.
Maybe, but the federal court will wind up imposing a desegregation order on Boston tougher than anything required under state law.
But not if we take a stand against it.
Against it? Larry,
We can't turn the clock back now. We've come too far down the road to turn our backs on the poor and the black.
Oh, yeah? What about the poor and the white? Huh?
Kevin, I've got to get out. The agenda around here has changed too much for me.
You think I've sold out, don't you?
Phil Collins offered me a job with the state.
The state? What the hell do you want to work for the state for? You think that's better than working for me?
You know, it's a tragedy what's happened to this city. The issue here is the separation of black and white, separation of rich and poor. Poor blacks and poor whites locked together in the same lousy school system. While those that can afford it get out. God bless America.
Hey, Colin, come here.
What?
Come here, look.
Keep it like this, okay? That's the way to do it.
This just into our News 95 studios. After years of torturous legal wrangling, federal judge Arthur Garrity has today finally handed down his judgment in the Boston School Committee segregation
case. My God, Garrity's finally come down with his decision.
In favor of the black parents.
It's a victory for the children of Boston. What it means now is this. The state plan will begin in some schools this fall while the court goes to work on phase two for next year. The school committee is now under orders to come up with a busing plan.
But Judge Garrity can forget it. I'll never vote for any plan that includes forced busing. That Garrity wants to destroy the entire school system in Boston. Well, we got other ways of stopping him.
We are here protecting our children and our brother and sister's children. They have the right to attend the school of their choice. Just because I'm white doesn't mean that the 14th Amendment doesn't refer to me either. I am white.
Notwithstanding objection of the Boston School Committee and many of the white parents in Boston, phase one of federal Judge Garrity's desegregation order went into effect today. As classes were to begin at the previously all-white South Boston High, an angry crowd of hundreds of people yelled taunts and threw sticks as the black students entered the building. Toward afternoon, the crowd grew larger and more angry. Rocks and bottles joined the verbal barrage. One police officer was injured, but the worst was yet to come. As the buses left the school, they also left the protective barrier of the police and were forced to run a gauntlet of jeering busing foes. Rocks were thrown, shattering windows on several of the buses. Nine black students and a monitor were injured. Black parents and students demanded more protection and talked of a school boycott until it could be provided. Anti-busing feelings ran very high and serious fighting between residents and police broke out several times.
And I take full
that it will never happen again. I can't give you the Lord's guarantee, but I'm asking you for another chance. No bus will go unprotected. No child will go unescorted. Then, if I can't produce, I'll fight alongside you.
Hey, guys, they're going to be busting the blacks in here.
Stop running on the stairs. Good morning, Tricia.
Hi, Mr. Powell.
Hi, Lisa. Hi. See you made the honor roll. Say, didn't I see a mom run a baked good sale down by the practice field?
Oh, yeah, she's working overtime to beat the buses. You know, raising money, painting signs, that kind of thing.
Oh.
Oh, I don't believe that. Give me the numbers again.
Yeah.
Is that the school or the district?
Hey, Frank, we just got the news. The court just issued its phase two. They're going to bust 1,200 black... They're going to bust 1,200 black students in here from Roxbury and the South End. 850 of our students out, starting next September. We got what, 1/10 of the city's students? We get stuck with 1/3 of the bus.
So why don't you keep that stuff out of the building and for after school? While you're at it, why don't some of you take a hike down to the Bunker Hill Monument? You pass it on the way to school. Think about the battle that was fought there, the lives that were lost, so the world would be reminded that all men are created equal. The way some of you are starting to act, you seem to think that some people are more equal than others.
Right.
Get back to your classes.
We know equality is important, Mr. Powell, but so is the neighborhood that we live in.
Come on. Yeah. You heard me now. Get back to your class.
When I look into the face of my black brother, I look into the face of Christ. There are some in this community who would lead you down the dead-end street of resistance to integration. This is against the law of the land and the law of God. I grew up in Roxbury, and I had the privilege to serve for 22 years in the Virgin Islands, where blacks and whites lived together in harmony.
Well, why don't you go back to those kids then?
Yeah.
Surely it's time that we brought this harmony home here to Boston.
Exactly.
Are you here for confession?
No. What I really came to talk about, Father, is my friend Bridget O'Connell. She tried to enroll her daughter, Elizabeth, in St. Catherine's and was turned down.
You are aware of the Cardinal. Order against using Catholic schools to escape busing.
Sister said it was because she hadn't contributed enough.
Your friend is a bigot, Alice.
Which sounds like extortion to me.
The church cannot allow itself to be used as a refuge.
No, Mary, buddy.
Slam the door, Cassandra. Gotta sign a Charles tale.
Just how many hand tools does it take to remove?
I'm scared, Hassan.
You want me to come with?
No, I'm scared for Cassandra. Going to school in Charlestown.
Cassandra, she's no sweet thing. She can take care of herself.
And that's what she wants you to think. Underneath, she's just a softie. Remember Cousin Rose Baker? He got beat up at a Navy Yard in Charlestown. He lost a kidney.
Rachel, that was 50 years ago.
You think it's changed?
Let's go talk to him, see how it goes.
What are all the cops for?
To check down the plane and help us flash.
Are you kidding? Jim says they're coming over in Carlo. He's going to ride up and down Bunker Hill shooting anything that moves.
Go on. Who told him that?
He's got a buddy on the course in Roxbury. They hear the talk. They know what's going on. He says the cops are going to come in here Wednesday like D-Day.
But defending who? Us or them?
Jeez, I got to keep my kids off the street. Good luck.
You're not letting them go to school, are you?
I don't know. That's something they got to decide for themselves.
Oh, way to go, Al. Way to support the boycott.
I need a note from Mommy.
Didn't you hear? They're coming over. They're back. Yeah, my brothers keep a lookout on the bridge. They got walkie-talkies and everything.
Ah, come off it, Donna.
No kidding, Lisa. It isn't safe. They just love to catch a white chick like you out on her own. Don't you know that?
Nice of you to come. Hello. You're welcome here. Four black parents and four white parents to our parents' racial ethnic council.
We aren't voting for nothing, Frank.
That's right.
Billy, the purpose of the council.
I ain't sitting in the same room with a bunch of niggers. And neither will my kids.
But we're doing that now. But couldn't we at least try to get along?
You walk out of this room, you care more about yourself than your own children.
Don't
even
talk to her.
All right, that's it.
Come on.
I'm walking.
I'm sorry. Pat, give us a break on this. I apologize.
How many of your friends are going?
Not many. Tina's parents won't let her.
Someone sent Frankie Butler's folks that did Cat in the Box.
Gross.
The only kid going to Roxbury.
I think that's terrible. Come on, kids, get out of here.
What? The cat?
The cat thing is disgusting. I mean getting on a bus.
The guy had 11 kids and can't afford parochial school.
What, are you standing up for him?
That's their business, and ours is ours. Now, you kids know how I feel. We gotta show the judge we're not gonna back down. Now, I hope you kids don't go. But I'm not gonna tell you what to do. Old enough to make up your own mind. Kevin? Billy?
You see me here, Ma. Uncle Cat made a football team.
If we don't go, Ma, it's like we're letting Gary keep us out of our own school. I'd rather fight busing from the inside. I don't care if they bring the army in there.
get out of here. Lisa. He's a good man. It's a raggedy school. They should have toned that sucker down a long time ago.
What about my school?
Well, I hear it's the newest school.
Wretched! Turn that thing down!
What about the townies?
There's a lot of prejudiced people in Charlestown. They didn't want me there, and they don't want you.
What'd they do to you, Mommy?
People standing across the street, yelling at us as we got off the bus. They got nigger and Zulu written on the walls. You try talking to them, they turn away.
That kind of stuff.
Yeah, that kind of stuff. They gonna call you a lot of ugly names. You gonna get spat at. Might even get pushed around some. But it's not the first time, and it won't be the last.
Why do I have to go to that school? Why can't I go to Rockville and Dorchester?
We gotta go through. You understand that? It's something you gotta go through if we are ever to get integration in this city.
Doing, Sam?
You were getting sleepy.
What?
You were not.
Thank you.
metal tongs with metal teeth.
What do you think? I'm going to take a bite out of you? Hey, this isn't even metal.
You see the sign? No objects that can inflict bodily harm.
Sure, I come halfway across town, scared to death, so I can beat up on Whitey with a 79-cent hair pick.
Where's your school card? I'm not going to argue with you. Hey, McGough, out of here. You graduated last year.
Who are you telling to get out of here? I live here. I'm a townie just like you.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
Where are the niggas? Upstairs already. Hi.
Hey, does anyone smell something peculiar in here?
They sit as far away as they can get and still be in the same room. When the teacher turns his back, they whisper, "Want a banana monkey man?" Dumb stuff like that. Then they throw stuff they know we can't throw back because there's more of them. Always one or two of them who seem like they want to be friendly, only their friends won't let them.
How was your first class?
10 whites, 3 blacks, glaring at each other, goading me to take sides.
So what did you do?
What did I do? I taught. The sea is calm tonight, the tide is full, the moon lies fair.
Ain't you never seen a nigger before?
I never saw one.
Why?
Not shoving us out of our school.
Someone shoving you, honey? I see you standing right there.
Well, I'm gonna be standing right here long after you're gone, honey.
That can't be too soon for me. I don't know what I did to get a sign of this rat hole in the first place.
Go back to Boogie Town.
I know your friend's even crazier than you are.
Cereal tastes boring, bland, and not so good, but it's high in fiber.
My cereal tastes tempting, terrific, and very good, and it's high in fiber.
Really? What is that?
New improved fruit and fiber.
New improved fruit and fiber.
Now they've added delicious crunchy oat clusters to all those juicy raisins, dates, and crispy walnuts.
Delicious.
And it's high in fiber, too.
New great tasting post fruit and fiber cereal. Why would you want your fiber any other way?
Now, back to cooking with Audrey.
Okay. Have we got our ingredients ready?
Yeah.
Raspy eggs, family?
There's nothing like DuPont Stainmaster Carpet for handling a pinch of this.
Measure the milk carefully.
And for dealing with a dash of that. But it's not a Stainmaster Carpet.
Wasn't that fun? Super DuPont.
If it doesn't say DuPont.
One all-purpose spray cleaner gives you over 50% more grease cutters than Formula 409 to clean just about anywhere.
Gee, that's fantastic.
You got it. Fantastic. More power, more places.
Attenzione! Give your hamburger an Italian accent with new Chef Boyardee Hamburger Italiano. Dinners you make with hamburger for an authentic Italian taste. New Chef Boyardee Hamburger Italiano. Mangia!
Volvo 240 has a reputation for surviving accidents, and we at Subaru have always been impressed by that. So we gave the Subaru Legacy Wagon unibody construction, like the Volvo 240. But we also gave it full-time four-wheel drive and anti-lock brakes, because the best way to survive an accident is not to get into one.
Factory-to-dealer cash incentives on selected models make it a great time to come into your Subaru dealer.
A missing child.
Bobby!
An angry promise.
One of these days, you're gonna screw up. When you do, I'm gonna be there.
A collision course with destiny. Knots Landing, Thursday.
Sugar and spice.
Meet two sisters with nothing in common.
What you call love, girlfriend. Bees call pollination.
One sweet.
Don't you think about anything else but men.
The other indiscreet.
Sometimes I think about that cute bunch.
Together, they're Sugar and Spice. Premiering Friday.
So I'm on TV with this big crowd yelling, "Nigga, go home." So I turn and pose like I'm a movie star. Going to for men, leaving them outside.
At my school, someone drew a picture on my desk of an African with a bone through his nose.
Oh, what, girl. Five white guys jumped Bruce Stone in the corridor and threw his books downstairs.
Well, I would have thrown them down the stairs.
Uh-huh. Oh, sure. You're going to throw five white guys downstairs in Charlestown.
That's right. You can't let them get away with it. You got to do something.
That's right.
You don't go getting into fights. You get suspended, no way you're going to get an education.
We didn't learn nothing today except filling out dumb cards.
Shoot, this jerk in an Elton John t-shirt blocks the door to history class, jumping back and forth, making monkey sounds till Miss Matthews tells him to take a hike.
Monkey sounds?
Glad to hear something good about somebody white.
That's right, Ma. It's a big old white world out there.
Then this chick in the girls' room, little Austin in, gives me this real heavy hate look. Like she's a witch and I'm supposed to die. So I turn and say, ain't you never seen a nigga before? In a real nigga voice.
You don't talk like that, Cassandra.
Why?
You're just looking for trouble. Now, if somebody else wants to start something, don't you be the one to oblige him.
Ma, why did they hit your fence?
I just turn and walk away, Frederick. They are just proving how inferior they are.
Oh, come on, Ma. Even the old-time religion says, an eye for an eye, tooth for tooth.
If I want a sermon, I will ask for it.
Amen.
Fighting broke out as buses bringing black students from across the city rolled in.
It was like
a massive.
They had these metal detectors set up in the lobby, and there were cops watching us like we were criminals or something.
What about the black kids? They were pretty quiet.
Are you kidding me? You should have heard the loudmouth in the girls' room calling our school a rat hole.
Oh, man. You got it.
Is that Dan?
I
want you kids staying up the streets tonight.
We're
not fighting cops, we're fighting busing.
Well, the cops are sure fighting us.
Look, I can't go running around after you kids with my neck hurting like there's a knife stuck in.
Nothing wrong with your neck, Ma, except us.
Are you saying I'm making this up?
Hey, is that me? Oh, no.
You know who the new American nigger is? The working man, that's who.
You consider yourself prejudiced, sir?
Yeah, I'm prejudiced. I admit it.
He's turned inside out by this. This whole deal is just bringing up so much stuff.
What's that?
It's the worst in everybody.
We up in the jackpot. Yes, of course. Look at him.
What do you think you're doing?
What? No, no, no. Say what?
Colin?
Put it down, come on.
Colin!
Here we are. A Louisville slugger. This bat helped win the Lexington Little League Championship back in 1956.
I mean, what you doing with it?
I'm gonna leave it right here in case of an emergency.
We started organizing a year ago. Busing in Charlestown, and now we have police attacking innocent citizens, dogs, paddy wagons. Do we want this happening day after day?
No!
We gotta give the kids more support.
And how are you gonna do that?
Well, there's a parade and motorcade this Sunday morning, and a petition to Tip O'Neill.
Oh, come on, Grace. What good will that do? What a yapping and marching. Big deal. Do you people really think that's going to make any difference? What we need is a little more rhyme here. What we need is a little action.
Oh? What kind of action are you talking about, Terry?
I'm talking about action in the streets. Putting ourselves on the line.
Our children are out in the streets. Would you sacrifice one of your own children?
Yes, I would, if necessary.
That Terry Corbin is nuts.
I don't know. I mean, he talks and talks, but what good is it marching around City Hall with a bunch of signs? I mean, that top of the hill stuff. Face it, we're project rats. Maybe we should act more like it. Get up and say that. No, go on, Al. Go on, stand up and say that. Go on, hey, quiet. Hey, yo, listen.
Can I say something?
Quiet.
Can I say something? I'm not preaching violence or anything like that. I mean, beating up Teddy Kennedy is not going to keep my kid off a bus. But I think we got to do more to make Garrity back down.
Bless your God.
Now, I think one thing the judge doesn't understand is what it's like being a townie.
Bless your God.
Now, most of us don't have much, but what we got a lot of is pride. That's what keeps us together, pride and our soul. Now, some top-of-the-hill townies are lucky enough to get their kids into Boston Latin, and some of them have got the money to send their kids to Malden Catholic, but...
I don't.
We went to Charlestown High School. That's our top-of-the-hill.
Yeah.
And nobody's going to tell me my kids can't go there.
That's it. You go, Mel. Glad you're here.
But what I think we should do is be more like Martin Luther King. Now, whether you agree with him or not, he had the right idea. If you don't like the laws, get out in the streets and say so. And stay there until you change them.
Yeah, that's
what I think we ought to do.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
bastard. If he could pray, so will the women of Charlestown.
Yeah.
Our Father, who art in heaven.
Father!
Hallowed be thy name.
Father, come pray with
thy kingdom come.
Come pray with thy Father.
You have spoken today with great dignity. The city has heard you. The nation has heard you. Don't spoil it now by forcing an unnecessary confrontation with the police.
Father, why are you against us?
Madam, I'm not against
you. Well, then
why
won't you pray with us?
Why not?
I pray for you every day.
No, not for us. With us. Pray with us here, now.
God, how I wish I could. But I simply can't take one person's side against another.
One person's side? Whose side are you on anyway? We're praying so they don't take our kids away. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. See, we don't need you in your Father.
Thy will be done.
We serve God, our heritage as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our trespasses. As we forgive those who trespass against us.
Why does he call the world a land of dreams? Then a place where ignorant armies clash by night. Anybody have an answer to that one?
Huh? They'll let us walk through single file, but only on the south side.
On the south side. What do they think? We are a bunch of cattle they can lead down a chute.
Come on, let's break through them.
Yeah. Do you think the cops want to be seen beating up a bunch of women on the news?
No way. Now keep your heads down. If they so much as touch you, they won't be able to hold this town, and they know it. All right.
Okay, got it. Come on.
Tuesday night, the schools erupt into violence.
Who do you think you are?
With kids from both sides paying the price. But anger also spreads to the home front.
They can stay here and do as they're told, or they can go with you and do what you let them.
And two families are stretched to the breaking point.
You can't join a boycott.
As Boston's fury intensifies, cracks appear.
Hi.
And the wall of hatred begins to crumble. Still, a test of conscience remains in the powerful conclusion of Common Ground. Tuesday,